Okay, hi there. Let's pretend like this is not the 17th time I'm doing this. If you start a new hobby, you start with the basics. You don't start painting by painting the Mona Lisa, you start painting by painting happy little trees, if even. So, if you want to start making games, it's a good idea to start with the basics. And a nice basic game to start with is one of the first games, Pong. There's a whole bunch of reasons why Pong is a nice introduction, because it doesn't bog you down with all the details on video game engines and the complicated stuff. This is pretty much as simplistic as it gets. But where do we start? Let's get some stuff on screen. Let's draw the paddles and the ball. Then it would be nice if they are in the center, because especially the ball is probably going to start in the center of the screen. I don't know, it depends from which version of Pong you're playing. And then if we're feeling adventurous, and depending on how long this video gets, thanks YouTube algorithm, we can attempt to make the little dotted line that goes down the middle. I feel that's a good place to start. Where are we going to do this? I'm going to use TIC-80. I like TIC-80. It's simple. It runs on anything. It uses Lua. Lua is a nice, simple programming language. It has only a few things that you need to learn, a few keywords, and then they're like Lego blocks. It's all about how you put them together. That's important, not so much what they are. I like being able to remember everything. I will, however, put a nice little cheat sheet for TIC-80 in the description that if you want, you can print out or keep open somewhere if you want to reference stuff, but I'll be explaining myself as I go. The point is that it's simple. And TIC-80 has everything we need without having to install complicated programs. I mean, I suggest if you're going to code along, which I recommend, strongly encourage, then I suggest you do install TIC-80. But I mean, if you don't want to, this is the website. This is the TIC-80 website. If you go to the link, this is what you'll get. If you click on here, you give it a second, there's TIC-80, and you can do stuff and go and code things. I mean, there's the code. I mean, I prefer the narrower without the shadow, but there's code and it runs and it can do stuff. Problem with this though, it saves in the browser. So if you do this and then later on your browser decides to update, it might disappear. So if you plan on following me on this whole journey, I suggest that you do install TIC-80 to your computer, which is easily done. There's the Windows version, the Linux version. This is open source, by the way. OS X, if you're on a Mac. Android has two options. You can install this APK if you know what you're doing and you're okay with sideloading stuff. Alternatively, it is on the Play Store. So, personally, I like the Play Store version. It has its own keyboard because there's a bunch of buttons on that you use when you're coding that's not on a standard phone keyboard. There's a Raspberry Pi version, which is also nice if you have a Pi 400 or a different Raspberry Pi, even a Pi Zero, I think it runs on. I'm not sure about a Pico. I don't think it runs on the Pico. The bare metal might run on a Pico. I don't know. I haven't tried. The 3DS version, interesting idea. Not sure how that works. Nintendo is not known for this kind of thing. Anyway, not the point. We're gonna make a thing. We're gonna code a thing. Let's get started. Okay, so this is TIC-80. Here we are. Don't stress too much about the version number. It's pretty much feature complete. It's practically version 1.0. They keep adding nice little features that make it nicer. You'll see some of them as we go. New, usually a good place to start. Creates a new cart. This is the standard stuff that's in a cart when you tell TIC-80 you want a new cart. Now, I am going to remove almost all of it because this right here is the basis of a TIC-80 program. I haven't given it a name. Let's give it a name. I'm going to be super organized and go into a folder I've prepared earlier. And then I'm going to save this as pong01.tick. And yes, that did flash that there I was overwriting an existing one. It's fine. I don't mind starting over. This is still early days. Still simple. Okay. Where was I? Oh, by pressing escape makes it switch to the code and or to the editor and to the console. If you're in the editor, command and or alt and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 switches to all the different things. We're only going to use number 1 for now because we only need to code. So, important stuff. A game loop is basically this. Any video game has a game loop that fires and keeps repeating as often as it can in the background. Now, in the case of TIC-80, this specific function runs at 60 frames a second. The engine itself handles the complicated things in the background about dividing by delta time, if you know what I'm referring to. In our case, TIC-80 means we don't have to worry about that. All we really need to care about is that this is firing at 60 frames a second, and anything we put in here is going to happen every time, you know, whatever, for every frame. Not the point. So, a game loop normally has three things. It looks for inputs from the user, then it updates whatever game logic has to update, and then it draws normally to the buffer, draws to the buffer, and then if the engine is taking care of flipping to the screen, then what it'll do is every X number of frames, so not X number of frames, but if it's, for instance, locked VSync to, say, 60 frames a second, then every time the screen is supposed to update, the engine will take whatever is in the buffer and just display it on your screen until the next time it comes around, takes whatever is on the buffer, displays it on your screen. We need to draw to the screen and we need to draw a paddle. So I'm going to make a new function and we're going to call it draw. End. In Lua, end is always a statement to say when stuff ends. Huh? See? Right there. What I like to do is I put a little comment. Yes, you can comment after a statement as well. I like doing this. I'm doing this so that I know that's the end referring to draw, so that later on, if my code gets really big and complicated, I know which end statement refers to which part of the encapsulation in case your tabs get broken. So this is how we're going to execute our draw function. Now the first thing we're going to do, in TIC-80 tabs are one space, not two, not four, a single. We are going to clear the screen, which is this, CLS. If you've ever worked in command prompt, should be very familiar. Linux users or Mac users should know clear. There's no reference to the actual console command. This is just a command inside TIC-80. That is going to clear the screen. Now, because TIC is going 60 times a second and it's calling draw 60 times a second, it's going to clear the screen 60 times a second. What does that look like? We can run our code two ways. Firstly, save. Yeah, or Control S works as well. I did that earlier. I do it habitually. In here, CLS or clear would also clear the screen. But if you type run, what's happening? Nothing's happening, because all we're doing is we are clearing the screen 60 times a second. So what else can we do? Let's print something on screen. Let's print the thing on screen that everybody prints on screen. So now we're looking at a function call. Function call has brackets, and we send it one argument, which is some text. Now if I run this, it says hello world in the top left corner. Now we can get a bit more fancy with that. If we move over to the sprite editor, these are the 16 colors that we can use for things in TIC-80. There's more, it gets complicated, but also if you go into advanced mode, you can set what these 16 colors must be, and you can copy in palettes. You can also change your bits, your color depth to be two, instead of 4 bits, it can be 2 bits or 1 bit, which gives you less colors, but a lot more space for sprites. There's also, this is the tiles. I know there's a sprite in there. Their first example is a bad example, but this is where you normally design tiles with the goal of putting them on your map. This is the map. There's your tiles. And I can grab a tile, place it, grab a tile, place it, and so on. Anyway, there's also a whole separate one that is your sprite sheet. This is where you actually draw your characters. We're not going to use any of this, because we are going to physically draw our graphics to screen. Reason I came here is to point out the colors. So there's white. You'll see at the top of the screen, it says color 12. I can't mouse over to it because then it disappears. But color 12, that's color 0. It goes up to 7 and then 8 and then up to 15. Now we are mostly going to be interested in these four because Pong is very grayscale. Originally Pong was one bit, which means it only had the background color and one other color. We, however, may use the fact that we have some more to play with. But we'll worry about that later. Hello world. The next prompt that comes in is where on the screen it goes, so we can put it at. Okay, at this point, here's a little picture. These are how the coordinates work in TIC-80. Top left corner is 0, 0. Bottom right corner is 239, 135. Because the screen resolution in TIC is fixed at 240 by 136. It's a standard 16 by 9 ratio. If you run this in full screen, then it scales that up to fill your screen. If you have pixel perfect scaling on, which I suggest that you do because it looks the nicest, it might add a bit of a border around the outside, but that is to make sure that you have nice crisp pixels. And trust me, it looks nicer that way. So if I put this at, say, 30, 20, it's going to move in and down. The next parameter in this thing is color, I think. So if I put 12, it should be white. It's white. So, them's the basics. Now, I like pseudocode, so this is going to happen now. Pseudocode is when you write out what you're going to do like this, and then go back and actually write the code. Pseudocode is often used to explain a programming concept without being bogged down by making it work in a particular language. But in this case, Lua is simple. So step one, we're going to draw petal one. Step two, we're going to draw petal two. Step three, we're going to draw petal three. Wait, there is no petal three. That's the ball. Step three is the ball. So, TIC-80 has a function called rectangle, or rect for short. This is to draw a rectangle, let's say 20 by 0, so it's going to be a little bit in, but that's x coordinate, so 20 pixels in from the left and right at top. And then we have width and height and color. So width is going to be, I don't know, 40, height 30, so it's almost square. Color, we were talking about 12, because 12 is white. Cool, look, a little square. But this paddle needs to be, let's start off with the paddle top left. Let's make it 10, no, wide, 4 wide, 10 tall. It's a bit small. 16 tall. It's better. Okay. To move it down a bit, make it 20. Bring it in a little bit from the edge. There we go. It's not doing anything, but it's up there. Okay. Oh, Control R, by the way. I'm not sure what that's called in on a Mac. Is how to quickly run the thing. For me, it becomes instinctual. Panel number two is going to be on the right side. Now, we said that that's the full width of the screen. We want to be 2 pixels in from the outside, and our paddle is 4 pixels wide. That makes 6. So 134. Then we wanted 20 pixels from the bottom so that it's in the same spot but on the other side of the screen. So 136, which is the total height, minus the 16 pixels tall that is, minus 2 pixels to move it a little bit away from the edge. Actually, 20 pixels, then it's the same distance from the bottom that the other one is from the top. Now I can leave it like that because you can actually do maths inside the parameters of a thing. Sometimes it's useful. So if I run this, I now have, look at that, there's a paddle on the other side. And there is a slight gap, 2 pixel gap, right there. Gives us a little space so that it's not up against the wall. But these don't do anything yet, they don't move, so we'll worry about that later. Next up, the ball, now. So where does the ball need to be? was going to say it's still a rectangle, so let's hijack this. Let's hijack the shorter one, paste it here. It needs to be, this is x, y, width, height, and color, which is still 12. Oops, x and y, width, height, color. So if it's 240 wide, it needs to be in the middle. Let's divide by 2, right? So 120. But if we make the ball a single pixel, it's not going to be fair. So let's make the ball 4x4. Which means if we want it exactly center, it needs to be 2 pixels left, so 118. And then Y, which would normally be 136 for the full height, half of that is 68, right? But then we also need to take down the 2 pixels to make this in the center. That, to me, looks pretty much like the center. Yeah, so we've got some stuff on screen. I'm happy with that.